Top spent a couple of years honing in on how they wanted to position their new brand before nailing it with 1991 Bowman baseball cards. Bowman was going to be the place to come for rookie cards. But that's pretty much an accepted part of hobby life these days. But Topps took slack in some corners for pushing the boundaries of rookie by including draft picks and other guys who had never seen the inside of a major league roster, and some who never would. And like everything else in the era, the set was and is too abundant on the market. Doesn't mean they're worthless, though. As you'll see on this list of the most valuable 1991 Bowman baseball cards, based on recent eBay sales for PSA 10 copies. Batter up! 1991 Bowman Mike Mussina rookie card, number 97. Mussina spent just over a year in the Orioles farm system before making his major league debut in August of 1991. He went 4-5 late that summer, but with a 2.87 ERA that portended good things to come, and soon. In 1992, Moose went 18-5 with a 2.54 ERA to finish second in the American League Cy Young voting. It was a pattern that would continue for years. Great won-loss records, but a paucity of rewards. And somehow, Mussina didn't win 20 in a season until his final season in 2008. By then, he'd been the cog in the Yankees' rotation for 8 seasons and had managed to raise his national profile a smidge through a slew of postseason appearances. His 270-153 record made him one of the winniest hurlers of his generation and eventually landed him in the Hall of Fame. Today, Mussina's Bowman rookie card sells for around $70 in perfect graded condition. 1991 Bowman Jeff Bagwell rookie card, number 183. The Red Sox famously traded Bagwell to the Astros late in the 1990 season in exchange for Larry Anderson. Hard to say the trade didn't work because Anderson was lights out from the Boston bullpen down the stretch, and the Bo Sox won the American League East crown. But Bagwell took over the starting first base job in Houston the next spring and didn't let go until 2005. In between, he became one of the most feared sluggers in his generation and an Astros legend. Bagwell also secured his place in Cooperstown, setting up today's $50 price tag for his 1991 Bowman rookie card, PSA 10. 1991 Bowman Jim Thome rookie card, number 68. In the midst of the steroid era, Thome was one of the few sluggers who just kept plugging along without huge peaks and valleys, and without the heavy stench of PED suspicions. We'll never know for sure who all used and who all didn't, but Thome's rep seems unassailable at this point, and most see his 600-plus home runs as legit. It's a big number, and Thome's Bowman rookie card follows suit at $40 in PSA 10. 1991 Bowman Chipper Jones rookie card, number 569. When this card was issued, Jones was still 2 years from his major league debut and 4 from his official rookie season. So yeah, Bowman was ahead of the curve. But it's all good now since Larry developed into one of the best third basemen of all time and a cornerstone of the great Braves teams of the 1990s. Today, his Hall of Fame rookie card is a $40 card in PSA 10 condition. 1991 Bowman, Ivan Rodriguez, rookie card, number 272. Once upon a time, Rodriguez was a phenom who was the Rangers' starting backstop as a teenager. That was 1991, when this $25 rookie card was issued. At the end of his career in 2011, Pudge was the grizzled veteran brought in to provide leadership for the Washington Nationals. In between, I-Rod built one of the most impressive catching careers ever and reserved his Cooperstown plaque early on. 1991 Bowman, Nolan Ryan, number 280. In July of 1990, Ryan won his 300th game. On May 1, 1991, he tossed his 7th no-hitter. It was all just par for the course for the Texas Ranger fireballer, whose legend exploded once he landed in Arlington in 1989. It was also all the more reason for Ryan's 1991 cards to catch on with collectors. And this Bowman version sells for around $20 today. 1991 Bowman, Ken Griffey Jr., number 246. Griffey was sort of in between in 1991. He was no longer an up-and-coming prospect or rookie, but he wasn't a fully baked Hall of Famer either. Within a couple of years, of course, Junior would fully blossom into the monster we all thought he'd be, and he took all his cards with him. This one lines up at about $20 in PSA 10. 1991 Bowman, Kenny Loft, and rookie card, number 565. Maybe it's because he was a speedster in an era that feasted on power. Or maybe it's because he was part of those 1990s Indians teams that just couldn't quite make it over the hump. Or maybe it's that he played one season or less for each of the 10 teams who didn't call Cleveland home. Whatever the case, Lofton never seemed to quite get his due as one of the greatest leadoff hitters of all time and one of the best players of his generation. At least his Bowman rookie card with full Astros rainbow cracks the list at $15, and you figure it might get a bump if Lofton makes it to the Hall of Fame. 1991 Bowman, Cal Ripken Jr., number 104. After taking a lot of flack for his keeping himself in the lineup as he inched closer to Lou Gehrig's record for consecutive games played, Ripken lashed back in the best way possible in 1991. Posting arguably the best offensive season of his career, Cal swept to his second MVP award, the first was in 1983, and cleared a path to Gehrig. The legends traded places on the streaks list in 1995. This Bowman card from Ripken's Shut Them Up Summer sells for about $10 in PSA 10. 1991 Bowman, Tim Salmon, rookie card, number 203. Once upon a time, the Angels featured a young outfielder who was among the best players in the game, one who could hit for average, take a walk, and clear the fences. And as if we weren't living in some sort of fantasy world, dude was named after a fish. So, Tim Salmon was a hotshot when he won the American League Rookie of the Year award in 1993, and he kept slugging, mostly, through 2006. What, you thought I was going to say Mike Trout? Salmon's 1991 Bowman is about a $10 buy in perfect slabbed condition these days. Like our video? Then like our videos and subscribe to our channel. WaxPackGods.com